Hello students, today I shall start with a new chapter, break. Okay. So first we'll go to the introduction part. So a break is a device by means of which artificial frictional resistance, that is important thing, artificial frictional resistance is applied to a moving machine member in order to retard or stop the motion of the machine. In the process of performing this function, the brake either absorbs the kinetic energy of the moving member or the potential energy of the object. This is also important, kinetic energy of the moving machine member or the potential energy of the object being lowered by hoist or elevator, etc. The energy absorbed by brake is dissipated in the form of heat. Okay, so the kinetic energy or the potential energy is converted or is absorbed by brake, and that absorbed energy is converted into heat energy. Okay, and due to this heat energy, the brake liner gets heated and its temperature rises. So so total amount of heat generated can be either formulated using your frictional force or using the loss of kinetic energy and potential energy by two methods. Okay, now I will go through this particular statement in detail on the next page. Okay, so the heat energy absorbed by the brake is dissipated in form of the energy absorbed by the brake is dissipated in the form of heat. Okay, the heat is dissipated in the surrounding air with or the water which is circulated through the passage in the brake drum. So the excessive heating of the brake lining does not take place. Okay. The major functional difference between a clutch and brake is that the clutch is used to keep the driving and the driven member moving together, whereas a brake is used to stop a moving member or to control its speed. Okay. Now, important thing, what is how the energy is absorbed by a brake? The energy absorbed by a brake depends upon the type of motion of the moving body. The motion can be either pure translation or pure rotation or combination of translation and rotation. Okay, the energy corresponding to this matter corresponding to this motion is kinetic energy. Okay, so if the body is under translation or under rotation or under combination of both, then total amount of energy in all these cases will be kinetic energy, but in few cases we shall also consider the potential energy also. Okay, now I shall rotate the slide. Actually, during scanning, the rotational tool was not option, was not on, that is why the problem appears. So I shall rotate the slide. Okay. Now, when the motion of the body is under pure translation means it's a linear motion. Consider a body of mass m, initial velocity v1, final velocity v2. So change in kinetic energy u1 equal to half of m v1 square minus v2 square. Okay, if the body after applying brake becomes the velocity becomes zero, the velocity of the body after applying the brake becomes zero, then we can say v2 equal to zero, then the expression becomes half of u1 equal to half of m v1 square. So this is the amount of energy, this is the amount of kinetic energy. Okay, that much of energy will be converted into heat. Loss in kinetic energy will be converted into heat. Okay, and that much of heat will be absorbed by brake liner. Some amount of heat will be dissipated to the air. This is the main fundamental knowledge. Okay, this is the main fundamental idea. Okay, here the frictional force applied, artificial frictional force. Okay, due to the application of artificial frictional force, the kinetic energy reduced, and that amount of reduction of the kinetic energy is get converted into heat, and that heat will be dissipated into the atmospheric air, and rest amount of heat generated will be responsible for the conversion, for the rise in the temperature of the brake liner. Okay, so when the motion of the body is under pure rotational, so same thing, I, that is your mass moment of inertia, I, okay, I equal to mq square, we know. So So change in kinetic energy of the rotation body is E2 equal to, you can see, half of I omega 1 square minus omega 2 square. Similarly, when the body gets stopped, then omega 2 equal to 0, then we can say U2 equal to half of I omega 2 square. Now, when the body is under combination of rotation and translation, so in that case, the total amount of energy absorbed will be E equal to E1 plus E2. E1 means energy absorbed due to translation, E2 is energy absorbed during rotation. Okay. Now, sometimes the brake has to absorb the potential energy given on the object being lowered by the hoist or elevator. Consider a body of mass M is being lowered from height H1 to H2 by applying the brake. Therefore, change in potential energy is E3 equal to mg H1 minus H2. Okay. So, we can see total amount of energy by the brake will be E1 plus E2 plus E3. Okay. Now, let us first consider that Fp is the tangential braking force or simple braking force or the frictional force acting on the contact surface of the brake dam. So Fp is the braking force. D is the diameter of the brake dam. N1 is the speed of the brake dam before brake is applied, and N2 is the speed of the brake dam after the brake is applied. So we can say average mean speed equal to N1 plus N2 by 2. Okay. Now we know that work done by the braking or the frictional force in time t equal to, so work done, that we know W equal to F into S. F means force, S means displacement. Okay. So we had the F is force is tangential force or braking force Fp into S. S means your displacement. Displacement means S equal to Vt, velocity in time. So velocity is the linear velocity, that means your pi dm, and this is when multiplied by T, we get the total work done due to frictional force or the braking force. Okay. Now the energy absorbed by brake must be equal to the work done by the frictional force. So I have calculated the amount of work done by the frictional force or the energy due to the frictional force. So that much of energy will be converted into heat. Okay. And that much of heat will be absorbed by brake, we can say. So here we can say that energy absorbed by the brake E equal to Ft into pi dn by T. So where you can, from there you can calculate the expression for Ft. Okay. Now we get the torque. What will be the torque? Torque will be force into distance. So force into distance. Okay. Force means Ft into R. R means d by 2. Where is the R is taken? Because we calculate the torque with respect to the center point of the drum. Now from center point to the periphery of the drum, the distance is radius R. So we get the Ft into R, because the tangential frictional force acts on the periphery of the drum tangentially. So from fixed point to the line of action of the tangential force, distance will be R. So R is multiplied with Ft, and hence we get the value of torque. So R is the radius of the brake drum. Okay. Once again, I have to rotate. Okay. Now we calculate the expression for heat absorbed by the brake drum. Okay. Or the heat generated. We can say the heat generated. Okay. We get the formula for heat generated by the frictional force, and hence we also get the amount of heat absorbed by the brake drum. Now there is also a consideration of heat dissipation. Okay. Whatever the amount of heat is generated by frictional force or loss in kinetic energy and potential energy, the amount of heat generated will be dissipated into atmosphere, and rest amount of heat will be absorbed by the brake drum. Okay. So what will be the amount of heat will be dissipated during braking? The energy absorbed by the brake and transformed into heat must be dissipated to the atmosphere to avoid the excessive heating of the brake liner. The temperature rise depends upon the mass of the brake drum, the braking time, and the heat dissipation capacity. So you'll get the leather and fiber material brake material, the heat generation will be 65 to 70 degree centigrade, asbestos 92 105 degree centigrade, automobile brakes with asbestos braking liner 180 to 225 degree centigrade. Just remember this data. Okay. Now, heat generated can be formulated using frictional force. The energy absorbed or heat generated is given by, now we get E. E is the value of amount of heat generated, or it can be said is the amount Hg. Okay. So, amount of heat generated, if it is calculated in terms of frictional force, then we get the mu Rn is the frictional force into V. V means your velocity. When force is multiplied with velocity, we get the expression for energy per second. So, energy per second in joule per second, we get the expression for amount of heat generated per second equal to mu into Rn into V. Okay. Now, what is Rn? Rn is the nothing but is the normal force. So, normal force means basically the force. Force means ki pressure into area. So, mu into Pa into V. Same. So, mu is the coefficient of friction. Rn is the normal force acting on the contact surface. P is the normal pressure between the braking surface. And A is the projected area. And V is the peripheral velocity of the brake drum. Okay. So, in terms of frictional force, we get the expression for amount of heat generated per second. Now, amount of heat generated per second can also be formulated using your loss of kinetic energy and potential energy. So, Hg equal to Ek plus Ep. Now, what will be the amount of heat dissipated? So, amount of heat dissipated using your convection, law of convection. Law of convection, Newton's law of cooling, we know. So, Q equal to, we know, Ha del T. So, in that way, Hd equal to C. C is your convective heat transfer coefficient. Del T means your T1 minus T2 temperature difference into area of radiating surface. This formula comes from Newton's law of cooling of convective heat transfer. Okay. Q equal to Hd equal to C into T1 minus T2 into AR. Okay. So, from this expression, we get the value of T1 minus T2. Okay, so this is the amount of heat dissipated by convection method. This is a natural phenomenon. Now, the rest amount of heat after dissipation. So, rest amount of heat will be absorbed by brake drum. Okay, and due to this reason, the brake liner or the brake drum temperature will rise. So, it has been found that 10 to 25% of the heat generated is immediately dissipated to the surrounding air. A rest amount of heat will rise the temperature of the brake drum. So, we get the rise of amount of heat. How we will get the value? Now, we know that Q equal to mcp del T. Okay. So, Hg equal to, we see, mc into del T equal to Hg. So, from there, we get the expression for del T. Understood what I said? We know how the temperature is gained. We know the how the temperature difference can be plotted. We know the basic expression for basic physics. Q equal to mcp del T. So, del T equal to Q by mcp. So, here Q is basically Hg. And M means a brake liner mass. And C is your specific heat of the material of the brake drum. So, from there we will get the calculate the value of del T. Now, what are the properties of material for brake lining? It should have a high coefficient of friction, and coefficient of friction must be constant. It should have a low wear rate, should have a high heat resistance, should have high heat dissipation capacity, should have low coefficient of thermal expansion. Why low coefficient of thermal expansion? Because we know alpha equal to del L by L del theta. That means if alpha is less, your del L will be less. That means when the coefficient of thermal expansion is less, that means your length difference, that means your incremental of length will be marginal, very less. And should have the adequate mechanical strength, should not be affected by moisture and oil. These are the important properties. Okay. Now, these are the types of brakes. Just go through it. Hydraulic brake, electric brake and mechanical brakes. Okay. So, in the mechanical brake section, we will go through the radial brake and axial brake. So, radial brake means the force acting radially. Shoe brake, band brake are the example of radial brake. Axial brake means force acting axially. So, disc brake and cone brake are the example of axial brake. Now, rotation once again. Now, just for an example, to solve the example. Okay. Note the points. Okay. So a vehicle of mass 1200, 1200 kg is moving down the hill at a slope of 1:5 at a 72 km per hour. It is to be sloped at a distance of 50 meters. If the diameter of the tire is 600 mm, determine the average braking torque to be applied to stop the vehicle, neglecting all the frictional energy except for the brake. If the frictional energy is momentarily stored in a 20 kg cast iron brake drum, what is the average temperature rise of the brake drum? The specific heat of the cast iron may be taken as 520 joule per kg degree centigrade. Determine also the minimum coefficient of friction between tire and the load in order that the wheels do not skid, assuming the weight is equally distributed among the four wheels. So the given data are like M is giving you vehicle load is 1200 kg. Okay. Slope is given 1:5. Velocity is given here 72 km per hour. So we convert this in meter per second unit. Now, after 50 meters of traveling distance, the vehicle gets stopped. So AC is 50 meters. Okay. Diameter of tire 600 mm, so radius 300 mm, 0.3 meter. The brake drum mass is your 20 kg. C is given. C means your specific heat is given 520 joule per kg degree centigrade. So here we see, like, first the vehicle have started its journey from this D point, and after 50 meter it has stopped at point F. So DF is your 50. So, we see the slope is 1/5, that means 0.2, that means slope means tan theta. Tan theta means perpendicular height divided by base, that is equal to 1/5, that is very less. So, for the simplicity of calculation, we can consider AC equal to CV, or you can say DF equal to FE, that is your 50 meter. So, from this relation, we can calculate DE. DE means your height difference, okay. That is required in order to calculate your loss in potential energy. Potential energy, loss in potential energy means mg del h or mg h1 minus h2. Here h1 minus h2 here dE. So height we get is 50 into 1/5, that means your 10 meter. Okay. So loss of kinetic energy half of mv square, we get this expression. For potential energy we get this expression mgh. Okay. Now we can say that total amount of energy, kinetic energy lost and kinetic potential energy lost, we have already calculated. Now, sum of total energy lost, the loss is due to the frictional force, and that much amount of force will generate the heat. Okay. So, we can say that when the vehicle stop at a distance of 50 meters, therefore tangential braking force, what will be the braking force? We have already given you the formula for calculation of the braking force. So nothing but we know that energy or work done equal to W equal to F into S. So force into displacement, we can say. So here we can find out force equal to energy by distance. So energy means Ek plus Ep, we calculate is divided by 50. 50 means your displacement. So we get the result of tangential braking force 7154.4. So force is when multiplied by radius, we get the torque. So this is the expression, this is the value of torque we get. Now the delta T, if we say the rise of temperature, the amount of temperature rise. Okay. Now I have given you one step jump. So where from you get the 357720? This we get from Ek plus Ep, that means Ek plus Ep, total amount of energy loss will be responsible for heat generation. So total amount of heat generation will be Ek plus Ep. So from this expression we get, when Ek is added with Ep, we get 357720. That is equal to MCP del T, that means your MB into C into del T. From this expression we get del T. Okay. Now mu is the coefficient of friction, Rn is the normal force. So normal force is balanced by weight. Weight means Mg. So we get the value of Rn. So tangential braking force is your mu into Rn. So from this expression we calculate the value of mu. Okay. So mu is 0.6 meter. such a type of numerical is a very common numerical for break chapter. Okay, just go through the numerical and try to practice, okay, more and more. And I have also given you an assignment based on the heap generation part, so that assignment is very easy, solve it. And I have also mentioned the steps or the hints to solve that numerical, solve it and submit it.